In this video, I'm gonna show you how to play Street Fighter vs Tekken online on PC. Since the PC version of the game can no longer be purchased on Steam and there is no forecast of when it will be back, we have to rely on RPCS3 to play this online on PC, if you never owned the Steam version before. I'll also leave a link to a Discord server dedicated for playing this game online, so if you wanna find players to fight, that will be the place. Now, let's start the tutorial. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below, and here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one, and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide. And then just select here on continue. And there you go, we have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here, the link will be down below, and on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer, and then you just click on download PS3 update and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you wanna go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and do not show again and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. For installing the game on RPCS3, back on the emulator folder here, there is this folder called Games that was already created when you installed the emulator, and this is the default folder that the emulator will scan for new games. And I can't show you here on the video where to go to get the game because this is against YouTube's policy, so you're gonna have to either dump your copy into your PC or find it online. When you're done, you're gonna leave it like this in a folder, and now you're gonna go back to the emulator, you're gonna click here on Games, and click on add games. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you're gonna double click on the games folder, click on the game folder once, and then click on select folder, and just like that the game will appear here. You can also close the emulator and reopen, because that also works for the emulator to find the game. Now, most likely when you install the game, it's going to be in the vanilla version. We don't have the patches yet, and it is required to be updated in order for it to be played online. And there's an easy way to update your games on RPCS3. Using this tool right here, Rusty PSN, the link will be down below as well. So here on this page, you just want to click here on the latest release available. It is version 3.7, and then just scroll down here to the bottom, and you have to download this file right here, the Rusty PSN EGI Windows.zip. Download this file if you are using Windows like I am. You can place it on the same emulator folder. Now back on the RPCS3 folder, the file is right here, the Rusty PSN that is, so you just have to extract the single .ex file that is inside of it with either WinRAR or 7-zip here. And then now you just have to double click here on the Rusty PSN.ex and the tool will open. Before you start downloading the patches, I want you to click here on this little gear, so you can change the download location for the patches. In my case, I like to create a new folder on the emulator folder here. called updates, just so that I can keep things organized, you know? And now go back to Rusty PSN and then select pick folder and then select that one updates folder that we just created. Remember, this is optional. This is up to you how you want to download this, but I like doing it like this. So now click here on save settings. Now to download the patches, we're gonna need the game serial code and we can get that on the emulator here. It is this code right here. And you're gonna click on the game with the right button, select the option from the bottom, copy info, and then click on copy serial. Now go back to Rusty PSN and you're just gonna paste the code right here like this and click on search for updates. Now it will find all the updates available for the game. There's only one here, so go ahead and click on download file, wait for it to finish. Now go back to RPCS3, click on file once again, but this time you're gonna click on install packages. On the emulator folder, double click on the updates folder. There's going to be another folder with the serial code of the game, double click on that, and inside the single update for the game. You can double click on it like this, click on yes to install the update. Should be pretty quick, it's a small update, and now the game is updated to version 1.08. Now we have to do the configuration to play this game online, and we're gonna start by creating the account on the RPCN network. So here on the emulator, click on configuration. Next, click here on RPCN. This window will show up and you're gonna start by clicking here on account. And then here, you're gonna click on create account. And first, you're going to create your username account right here. So select the name that you want to use and then click on OK. And here, you're gonna type the password that you want to use, of course. Then click on OK. And lastly, you're gonna type the email that you have so you can receive the token code, so you can access the online functionalities of RPCN and play the game online. Click on OK and this window will show up saying that you have created your account, but you need the token code on your email to activate your account. So head over to your email inbox and you're gonna receive a message exactly like this one that says your token for RPCN and then the code right here. So obviously you're gonna copy your code as such and paste your token right here and then select OK. Now the username that you have created is going to show up right here. So lastly, just click here on test account to make sure that everything worked fine. And there you go. You're gonna see this message here saying your account is valid. You're good to go now. So click on OK and you can close this down too. You notice that there is a friends option here available and you can actually add other people that also have a RPCN account to play with them online. So if you know someone that wants to play online as well, you just have to click here on friends and then click on add friend and then type his ID right here and then add him and then add that person as a friend. With this part completed, there's only one more thing to do for the online. You're gonna click on the game with the right button and then click here on create custom configuration. On this window that showed up, you're gonna click on the network tab here and make sure that the network status is set to connected. Leave the DNS, IP, and byte address to the default numbers here. You don't have to change that. And under PSN status, make sure you change from disconnected to RPCN. That's all we need to do in order for this game to be online. And since we are here on the settings window, let's do some configuration from the game. The default settings of the emulator work just as fine for this game, but there are more settings we can do here. First is making sure that the render is set to Vulkan. This is the best one, but if your GPU does not support that, you're only gonna have OpenGL. But the best one is Vulkan here. Change the anisotropic filter from auto to 16x. This has minimal impact on your GPU. And if you want to increase the game's native resolution, keep the default resolution at the recommended value here and increase the resolution scale. You can go all the way to 4K. This game runs fine on it. This is gonna depend on how strong your GPU is, of course. Now, you can also go here to the emulator tab and disable the show trophy pop-ups, PPU compilation hint, and shader compilation hint as well. They can be annoying because every time the emulator is doing one of these, you're gonna get a notification on the left bottom side of the screen, and I just like turning them off. Now, we're done here, click on apply and then save custom configuration. And lastly, we have to configure the controller. Click here on pads. And this emulator has an automatic mapping function. So if you already have your controller plugged in, you're gonna select it here on the handlers tab and just choose the controller you're using. In my case, I have a Xbox controller, so I'm gonna click here on X input, and just like that, the emulator will do the configuration for me. You can change individual inputs if you feel like it, and you can also use keyboard as well. When you're done, click here on save and we can finally start the game. So double click on it. And when you start it for the first time, it's going to compile the PPU modules, but it shouldn't take long. It's going to depend on how strong your CPU is. And like I said, all the online modes are working here. If you want to play Ranked or Endless Battle, the leaderboards are also working as well for other RPCS3 players. And you can also create a lobby and invite your RPCN friends, but I don't think it's working yet, unless if the game has an invite list function. But the matchmaking is working, so if your lobby is open, other people can find it through matchmaking. I have many tutorial videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to check out my other stuff, subscribe to the channel, and also leave a like on this video. Have fun playing, thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.